Hello out there. This is Dr. Sachin Kale. Welcome to another podcast. This time we are discussing hepatitis E. We'll have a brief introduction about what hepatitis is, and then we'll discuss two tests: antibody IgM against hepatitis E and IgG antibody against hepatitis E, of which IgM antibody is the more commonly advised antibody for detection of hepatitis E infection. But as is our custom, before going to the podcast, let's discuss news that made a big impact this week. And that news was about Indian Army's surgical strike against terrorist launch pad, destroying the terrorist launch pad in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. This made such a big news and it caused such an excitement all over India that social media, Twitter, Facebook and WhatsApp was overflowing with tweets and messages related to this news. What caused such excitement? Basically, this is very uncharacteristic of us. We usually don't do anything even if something bad happens to us. We just protest and that's it. But this time the story was different. There was something proactive that was done, and that's the reason there was so much excitement. So with that, the surgical strikes that Indian Army carried out, we have to go with our pathological strikes, and we are striking hepatitis E in this podcast. So what is this virus? It is a single-stranded RNA virus coming from Kale virus family. Route of transmission is fecal-oral. So we have two viruses of hepatitis A, B, C, D, E spectrum that are fecal-orally transmitted. First is, of course, the hepatitis A, and second is hepatitis E. The rest, that is B, C and D, are transmitted parenterally. So incubation period is just 4 to 5 weeks. Frequency of chronic disease is never. Diagnosis is usually done by IgM or IgG antibody against hepatitis E virus, or by PCR for hepatitis E virus RNA. So this is relatively an indolent disease, just like hepatitis A, but it poses special risk if it happens in a pregnant woman. Why? Because these women are likely to develop fulminant hepatic failure, and that can cause mortality. So apart from that, it's all right. It's relatively okay virus to have. Now coming to the first test, that is IgM antibody against hepatitis E virus. Positive results confirm the presence of acute or recent hepatitis E infection. Recent means in the preceding 6 months. So positive results confirm the presence of acute or recent hepatitis E infection. And negative results indicate absence of acute or recent hepatitis E infection. Then there can be sometimes indeterminate results also, which may be seen in acute hepatitis E infection with rising levels of anti-hepatitis E virus IgM. Acute hepatitis E infection with rising levels of anti-hepatitis E IgM antibodies. So they are not high enough, but they are rising. So that can be cause of one indeterminate result. Also, recent hepatitis E infection with declining level of anti-HEV IgM. Recent infection with declining level of anti-HEV IgM antibody can also cause indeterminate result. The third cause of indeterminate result is acute hepatitis E infection due to HEV genotype 2 strains. So there are 4 strains, 1, 2, 3 and 4, of which second strain can cause indeterminate results. So 3 and 4 are the strains which can be there more in pigs and other animals compared to humans, while the strains 1 and 2 are more commonly found in humans. Then fourth reason for indeterminate results may be cross-reactivity with non-specific antibodies, that is false positive results. In such cases, repeat testing of serum for anti-HEV IgM and anti-HEV IgG in 4 to 6 weeks is recommended to determine the definitive HEV infection status. Sometimes there are unreadable results also, which indicate the presence of unusually strong non-specific reactivity of the assay strip background that obscures proper reading of the bands. And such findings are usually due to non-specific binding of non-hepatitis E IgM antibodies. Non-specific binding of non-hepatitis E IgM antibodies, some other antibodies, in patient serum to the HEV antigens present on the assay strip. So some different antibodies than hepatitis E, which might be present in patient serum, bind to HEV IgM antigens present on the assay strip and cause such unreadable results. Repeat testing with anti-HEV IgM screen and anti-HEV IgG in 1 to 2 weeks is recommended in such cases. So picture might become more clear in 1 to 2 weeks. Then coming to IgG antibody against hepatitis E virus. Positive results indicate past or resolved hepatitis E infection. Negative results indicate absence of previous exposure to hepatitis E virus. So past or resolved hepatitis E infection will be flagged by positive result, while absence of previous exposure will lead to negative result. So this is the utility of IgG antibody. But borderline results may be seen in certain situations, and those situations include: number 1, acute or recent hepatitis E infection with rising level of anti-HEV IgG. Levels are not high enough but rising. That would lead to borderline results. Second reason for borderline results will be cross-reactivity with non-specific antibodies. So this is the bane of antigen-antibody reactions, the false positive results. What to do in such situations? We have to do repeat testing of serum for anti-HEV IgG in 4 to 6 weeks. How many weeks? Repeat testing in 4 to 6 weeks. It is recommended to determine the definitive HEV infection status. So that is about IgG antibody. So in this podcast, what we saw was the utility of IgM antibody and IgG antibody in diagnosis of hepatitis E virus infection. Hope you like this podcast, and if you like this podcast, don't forget to share, subscribe and like. This is Dr. Sachin Kale signing off from his weekly podcast. Thank you and see you again.